Tamon and Jackie, good evening. The family tells WGN the 2-year-old boy and the 9-year-old girl passed away sometime last night between 9:30 and 10 o'clock. Many people have been stopping by here at the growing memorial outside of the home to pay their respects. Many of them telling us they've never met the family but felt the need to show support. It's proving to be a loss that is being deeply felt within the community. A family member tells WGN the two other children who were critically injured in a house fire earlier this week have passed away, identifying them as 2-year-old Emery Day Stewart and 9-year-old Autumn Day Stewart.
It's just been rough on us, even though, like, again, like, we don't have a personal connection to the family, but it's just like, you know, like, we could be in their spot at any day.
Yasmin Corral couldn't help but get emotional as she thought of her family while paying respects at the memorial.
I have a lot of younger sisters, and my dad's always out of work. Sorry,
So you connect to it personally?
No. I can't imagine what he's going through.
Corral lives in the Montclare neighborhood where the Stewart family's home went up in flames Tuesday evening, claiming the life of 7-year-old Ezra Day Stewart. The mother and wife, 36-year-old Summer Day Stewart, passed away from her injuries Friday. The family says Summer's memory will live on through organ donation.
Just know that if he needs anything, we're here, we live in the same street.
The family describes Emery as a happy little boy who liked to play with toy cars, adding that they were at his bedside the last few days until his final moments. Autumn is described as the family's little lady who was very creative. She loved to sing, loved people, and was very outgoing. It's a tragic loss that is felt throughout the community as flowers, stuffed animals, and balloons have been placed at the Stewart's front steps.
We wanted to come here and, you know, drop something off and do a little prayer.
Many now sharing love and support for the father, husband, and Chicago firefighter impacted by the loss.
Despite not having to know them personally, everyone's worried and praying and wishing him a sense of peace. You know, I know that that must be very difficult right now, but like knowing that he's not alone.
Chicago firefighters have organized an effort to help raise funds to pay for funeral expenses. You can find that information on a flyer posted here outside of the home, but also on our website. Reporting live from the Montclare neighborhood, Christine Flores, WGN News.